Falling asleep in a bus. A 9-year-old pupil, Alice, slept late the previous night. When she got up the next morning, she felt sleepy. She was yawning most of the time. She had a wholesome breakfast, a half-boiled egg, two large butter and ham sandwiches, and a cup of milk. Soon, she bade goodbye to her parents and took a bus to school. While she was in the bus, she fell asleep. No one woke her up when the bus reached her school. For the next 30 minutes or so, she continued her sleep. Then she heard someone calling her, "Wake up, girl! The bus has already reached the interchange." Alice was shocked. "What? The bus has already arrived at the interchange? I must have fallen asleep." A day at the playground. Alice and her 10-year-old brother, Tom, were at a playground. It was 10 o'clock in the morning. The weather was sunny. Many children were already in the playground. They were young and active. There were swings, seesaws, slides, merry-go-rounds, and sand pits. Laughter and excitement filled the air as the children played among themselves happily. Some were swinging to and fro. A few were going round and round. Others were going up and down. Alice and Tom climbed up the slide. They were filled with excitement as they slid down. They loved every moment of it. To them, going down the slide was fun. Using a zebra crossing. A primary two pupil, Alan, was leaving the school gate after school. His bag was slung across his shoulder. He walked on the pavement. Soon, he came to a zebra crossing. He saw many pedestrians walking across it. All vehicles came to a halt. Without any further delay, he followed the pedestrians. He had to cross to the other side of the road. He walked across the zebra crossing. He soon reached the other side of the road safely. He said to himself, "A zebra crossing is very useful to pedestrians. It helps them to cross the road safely. I'll use it more often." Nearly tricked by a stranger. A little girl, Mary, was skipping in a public playground one fine morning. She felt so carefree as she had finished her homework. A male stranger appeared and asked her, "Excuse me, girl. Your father just had a fall. He sent me to fetch you home." Mary was stunned. "My father? Where is he now?" the stranger added. "He was in his shop when he fell." Mary thought to herself, "My father went to Hong Kong early this morning. I saw him board the plane. This stranger must be a bad person." Mary acted fast. Seeing a policeman passing by, she shouted, "Help! Help! I'm in trouble!" The stranger was taken aback. He started to flee, but the policeman caught him after a short chase. A day at the zoo. One bright Sunday morning, Father, Mother, and Alice went to the Mandai Zoo. Alice, a 10-year-old girl, was very excited to see so many kinds of animals in the zoo. They saw the zookeeper feeding the lions with huge chunks of meat. The lions were kept in a high enclosure. For the next 30 minutes or so, They spotted polar bears, deer, camels, leopards, elephants, monkeys, and orangutans. They loved every minute of seeing them. Soon they came to an high enclosure where a rhinoceros was kept. It was a large, heavy, thick-skinned animal with a horn on its nose. A minute later, they passed by a cage where poisonous snakes were kept. Birds and mice were also kept in it. When the snakes were hungry, the birds and mice would become their meals. A morning at the waterfront. It was an ordinary weekday morning. A pupil, Simon, and his uncle, Mr. Pang, were in the harbor. Oil tankers, ocean-going passenger liners, fishing trawlers, and cargo ships were anchored nearby. Simon was fascinated by such a sight. He had never seen such ships before. He was very curious and excited. They went near to have a closer look. Simon pointed excitedly at a crane. "What is it doing, Uncle?" His uncle, Mr. Pang, replied, "That crane is uploading sacks of rice from the ship to a waiting lorry." At another ship, able-bodied laborers were loading canned sardines, rice, and water into its holds from a truck. Simon saw many workers at work in the harbor. It was a very busy place. A fall. A primary two pupil, Dorothy, was eating an ice cream on a pavement one hot afternoon. It was a delight to her. She did not pay much attention to the objects around her. At this juncture, a banana skin was lying on the ground nearby. She did not notice it. All of a sudden, she stepped on it unknowingly and slipped. She fell heavily to the ground. She screamed, "Ouch! It's painful! Someone helps me!" However, there was no one around. After a minute or two, she got up to her feet. She suffered bruises on her right leg. Blood was oozing from her wound. She limped painfully to her home, which was 2 streets away. Fishing by a lake. It was a fine Sunday morning. An angler, Mr. Lee, was fishing by a lake. The lake was teeming with fish. The scene was quiet and deserted. With his finish line in the water, he waited patiently. Soon, shouts of delight were heard. "I've got it! I've got it! Hooray!" He shouted for joy. He felt something tug at his line. He pulled up the line. He caught a large fish at last. His rattan basket was nearly full of fish. He then put a big worm on the hook. He used worms as bait to catch fish. Soon he cast the line into the peaceful water. That day he had a good catch. A cut in the hand. Jeffrey, a teenager, saw a red ripe apple on the kitchen table. It looked juicy and crispy. The time was 2:30 p.m. Feeling hungry, he wanted to eat it. He took out a knife from a drawer and started to cut the fruit. He was not careful. The knife slipped off his hand. His left thumb was cut. The wound looked bad. It was bleeding. Jeffrey screamed in pain. "Help me! My left thumb is bleeding! It's painful!" His elder sister, Molly, rushed out of her room on hearing his cries. She consoled him. "You'll be all right." She later applied medicine on his wound. Taking shelter in an old attap hut. A 9-year-old boy, Tommy, was crossing a wooden bridge in a village. He was going to his aunt's house when suddenly a dog chased him. He took fright and ran for his life. There was no one around at that time. The dog barked as it ran after him. Tommy acted fast. He took out a meat bun from his pocket and flung it behind him. It was to distract the animal and stop it from chasing him. It worked. Tommy saw an old attap hut nearby and took shelter in it. What a relief! The hut was vacant. Nobody resided in it. Panting, Tommy looked around and found a place to rest. The hut was full of cobwebs. Struck by lightning. A swimmer, James, was taking a stroll along the sandy beach one early afternoon. All of a sudden, the sky turned overcast. A strong wind was blowing. Heavy rain soon fell. James ran to seek shelter. He ran to a shady tree. He took shelter under it. He said to himself, "I hate the rain. What a relief." A minute later, thunder and lightning was heard. Lightning struck the shady tree where James was taking shelter. James was found lying motionless on the ground. He had been hit by lightning. Caught in a traffic jam. A motorist, Henry, was on his way home after work. He was driving along a two-lane highway. Traffic was heavy. All of a sudden, there was a loud crash. A lorry had collided with a car. All traffic came to a standstill. Henry had to slow down. He was caught in a traffic jam. The accident held up the traffic on the highway. Traffic policemen came to investigate the cause of the accident. For the next half an hour, Henry was still held up in the traffic jam. A girl in distress. A little girl, Alice, was going to a provision shop two streets away. She had to run an errand for her mother. She had to purchase half a kilogram of sugar. Halfway, she was not careful. She dropped her money into a muddy drain. It was a dollar coin. She was in tears. The drain was deep. The water was muddy. She could not see her money. She tried to use a long stick to retrieve her money. However, it was useless. She sat on the pavement and looked very sad. An honest girl. A 9-year-old female pupil, Susan, was in the school canteen during recess. After having her food and drink, she went to play with her classmates, Lucy and Mary. They played a game of blind man's buff. As her classmate, Lucy, was blindfolded, Susan and Mary went to hide. Susan hid behind a bush. Suddenly, she spotted a thick wad of $5 notes. She looked around for the owner. She found none. Soon, the game was over. Susan picked up the cash and handed it to the principal. "Good morning, headmaster. I found the money behind a bush." Her principal praised her for being an honest pupil. Susan did not keep the money for her own use. An afternoon at a shopping center. A housewife, Mrs. Tai, and her 8-year-old niece, Molly, was in a modern air-conditioned shopping center. They mingled with a large crowd of shoppers and tourists. There was a wide range of shops selling different merchandise: clothes, shoes, bags, watches, jewelry, household goods, and mechanical products were on sale. Sales girls were very busy as they attended to many customers. Soon, cash and goods exchanged hands. Mrs. Ty and Molly took an escalator to the first floor. They entered an emporium. They wanted to buy toothpaste, handkerchiefs, washing powder, a glass vase, cooking oil, and sugar. They pushed a trolley to their shopping convenience. At 5 p.m., they took a taxi home. Having a meal by a dustbin. One hot afternoon, a boy was eating cakes close to a dustbin. The dustbin was without a lid. It was filled with rubbish. Mosquitoes and houseflies were swarming all over the bin. The stench was terrible. Then a kind man appeared and advised him, "Boy, you cannot eat your food here. It is not healthy." The boy did not pay much attention to the kind man. He continued his meal. That evening, he had a stomachache. That night, his mother took him to hospital. The doctor told his mother that he had eaten unclean food. The day a boy heard a bird. It was a bright Monday morning. The sun was shining brightly. A boy, James, was up to mischief. Carrying a catapult and some pebbles, he wanted to shoot birds. He entered a public garden. Birds were chirping high up in the trees. James looked up and spotted a bird high up in the tree. He put a pebble on the catapult and aimed it at the bird. Soon the pebble found its target. The bird fell to the ground. It was hurt. 10 minutes later, he injured another 4 birds. It was wrong of him to hurt birds. On a hunting trip, a hunter, Mr. Pang, was carrying a rifle. He was in a dense jungle. He wanted to hunt tigers. A tiger skin could fetch a high price. He could earn a handsome profit. He crept steadily among the trees. He was on the lookout for prowling tigers. It was very hard for him to spot a tiger in the thick undergrowth. All of a sudden, he saw a tiger at a distance. He acted fast. He raised his rifle and took aim at the tiger. It was eating a deer. A shot rang out and the animal dropped dead. Mr. Pang was delighted. A flood. The scene was a rural village. The time was 9 o'clock in the morning. Many villagers were going to the fields to harvest the rice crop. Halfway, they had to turn back as heavy rain fell. It lashed the village for the next 2 hours or so. The villagers were kept indoors by the rain. They watched helplessly in their homes as the water in the river rose to a dangerous level. The river soon overflowed its banks. The village was flooded in no time. At this juncture, the rain became heavier and heavier. The villagers became frightened. They climbed onto the roofs of their attap huts for their safety. An absent-minded housewife. A young housewife, Mrs. Pang, was on her way to buy a kilogram of sugar and post a letter. As the pillar box was nearer to her home, she wanted to post a letter first. When she reached the pillar box, she was absent-minded. She put in her purse instead of a letter. Then she walked away. When she arrived at a provision shop, she asked the shopkeeper for a kilogram of sugar. The shopkeeper was shocked when he received a letter as payment. The shopkeeper asked her, "Excuse me, lady, you have made a mistake. It is a letter." Mrs. Pang apologized to the shopkeeper. "I'm so sorry. I must have posted my purse."